Hey guys, my name is Marta, welcome to my channel, and today I'm going to be talking about Bel-Ami by Guy de Maupassant. This is a 19th century French classic in which we follow Georges Dugoy, who is a French man who has just come back to Paris from Algeria and is now looking to get a better job in order to rise in society. One day he meets this old friend of him who helps him get a job in the journal he works at. And after getting this job, we will see how our main character, Georges Dugoy, also known as Bel-Ami, will not be completely satisfied with what he has and will always be trying to get more. And with that, get also richer and richer. This book doesn't follow any specific plot, but is more of a character study of Bel-Ami, or Georges Dugoy, however you wanna call him, who is presented at us as this very ambitious person who will do whatever he can in order to get richer and richer and to be seen as this very important person in politics and in the journal and in the French society in general. Through the novel, we get to see how our protagonist won't shy away from using other people in order to get these positions he wants to get. He will be constantly using women in order to achieve these better positions, and he will try to use his own beauty in order to seduce them. By this presentation of our main character, you would initially think that he is someone you will hate while reading, but actually one of the most interesting things about him is the fact that you can't help but like him a little bit. He is a very interesting, very well-constructed character that no matter how morally ambiguous his intentions and actions are, you will be fascinated by him as a person and you will be constantly intrigued about what he's going to do next in order to get what he wants. The rest of the characters that appear in the novel share the same trait with our main one, and all of them are guilty of having some flaws. Cheating is one of the main topics addressed in the novel, and you will get to see how all of the important characters in the novel either cheat with their partners or are victims of this cheating. In terms of the female characters, even though most of them are used by your main character, Maupassant does a great job developing them, and you really get to see how they aren't these innocent women that you sometimes see portrayed in classic novels, but that they have their own personality and they have their own strengths. For instance, Madeleine Forestier, who initially is the woman to our main character's friend, is a very smart woman who basically does everything for his husband. Besides this study of our main character, Bel-Ami, the book is also a study of the French society in general. You really get to see how corrupted the fields of journalism and politics are. You really get to see from an inside point of view how manipulative they are, how they write for their own good, and how they hide away some facts in order to show the audience what they want the audience to see. One of the themes that is addressed in this very ambiguous way is the theme of colonialism, a theme that is present in the novel from the very beginning. As our main character gets the job in the journal after writing an article about his experience in Algeria, the theme of colonialism is addressed in the novel from the perspective of the colonialists, so you get to see the use of this country for their own good, so in order to get rich. Another theme that ties into our main character that is also explored in the novel is the theme of social classes and the differences between social classes. The book follows our main character trying to reach a good position in society, and you really get to see through the novel how he is even ashamed of his past as someone who comes from a lower class. There is a scene where he is with a woman with whom he is having an affair, and you really get to see how he is even a bit ashamed of his past. He doesn't really want her to meet his parents, and when they do, and she meets them, you really get to see how judgmental he is, how he doesn't feel comfortable there, and how he sees them as inferior people. And last but not least, another theme that is addressed in the novel is the theme of death. Death is presented as in the novel through two different points of view, one of them being a character dying, and this character, whose name I won't say because of spoilers, has to go through a very painful, slow death. And you really get to see how much he struggles through his last days, how in much pain he is, and it's really, really hard to read. And the other way death is presented at us is through the character of Norbert de Baron, who is a poet and who has this very philosophical conversation with our main character, and basically talks about death, about how ephemeral life is, about how he sees death everywhere. It is a very beautiful passage that really makes you think and reflect on life. And in according to critics, especially to the one who wrote the notes in this novel, that is one of the things that preoccupied the author the most, so it was really interesting to see it reflected in the novel. Last but not least, I would like to talk a bit about the writing style. Maupassant's style is way more simple than the one from other authors of the same time period. He is more straight to the point and doesn't drag with the descriptions. The writing is, as I said, very easy to follow, and the book is very, very engaging. I didn't get bored in any moment, and while reading it, I didn't feel like anything could have been left out of the story. The author also has this humorous side to it. There are some scenes that are really, really funny and that really made me laugh, and those humorous scenes are mixed with the more serious ones being the ones that talk about death and all those things that I talk about, or the ones that are more of a study of the society and that are filled with politics, with talk on politics, and that really make you see how corrupted this world is. Also, the ending of the novel is something that I really have to highlight. I really, really like the ending. I like how, in a way, it was open, the way that you can see what's going to happen in the future. You really get to see at the very end how our main character's story isn't finished with this novel, and how he will continue to try to reach a higher position to the one he currently has. Overall, I have to say that I really, really enjoyed this book. I gave it 4.5 stars, and I wouldn't be surprised if it was on my favorites of the year. It was a very satisfying read that I really, really enjoyed and that kept me entertained all the time. The characters were very interesting to follow, the story was fun, and at the same time made me think and reflect on the society of the time. It's a book that I recommend to anyone, no matter if you are not a huge fan of classics, because it is very simple, it is very fun, and I am sure anyone could enjoy it. So that was all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and comment down below if you read Bel-Ami or if you read anything else by Maupassant. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you want to see more from me. Don't forget to give this video a like if you enjoyed it, and I hope your day's gone amazing, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!